would you consider the current Egyptian regime an ally of the United States?
I don't think that we would consider them an ally, but we don't consider them an enemy.
Egypt is an ally. It's a major non-NATO ally.
Correct.
And you neglected to mention that. And that major non-NATO ally status is something that you guys have celebrated ever since the 70s, when they were among the first batch of countries, along with Israel, to get that distinction. So is Egypt an ally, or is it not an ally? And if it is not an ally, in the sense of the word, in the sense of the being a major non-NATO ally, is Israel not an ally either? Is Japan not an ally?
Well, Japan has a treaty alliance with the United States.
So Pakistan and India that don't have mutual defense treaties with the United States, they're major non-NATO allies, but you guys don't really think they're allies. Is that the message you're trying to send? Because that's the message the president did last night, unless you've decided that Egypt no longer qualifies as a major non-NATO ally.
Well, that was certainly, I don't think, the intention. I'm going to refer you to the White House for further parsing on this.
So forget about the president's words. You're saying that the administration, the State Department, still regards Egypt as a major non-NATO ally, and it is still a recipient of all the privileges that that entails.
Yes.
Og så til vores hjørne, hvor vi ser på politikernes retorik. Denne gang skal vi en tur over Atlanten, for godt en uge siden havde præsident Barack Obama besøg af Prime Minister Thorning-Schmidt.
Well, I want to welcome Prime Minister Thorning-Schmidt to the White House and to the Oval Office.
Og som du måske hørte i vores radioprogram på P1, så brugte præsident Obama en flot boksemetafor til at forklare Danmarks betydning i verden.
That's fairly typical of the way that Danes have punched above their weight in international affairs.
Ja, det er dejligt at få ros. Vi slår hårdere end vores vægtklasse berettiger til. Men hvor meget skal vi egentlig lægge i de ord? Gør vi det ifølge Barack Obama bedre end for eksempel nordmændene? Lad os høre, for Norges statsminister Jens Stoltenberg har også været på besøg i Det Hvide Hus.
I've said this before, but I want to repeat. Norway punches above its weight.
Norge slår altså også hårdt. Men hvad så med Holland? Her er regeringschef Mark Rutte på besøg hos Obama.
We have no stronger ally than the Netherlands. They consistently punch above their weight.
Og hvad med Irland?
Ireland punches above its weight. It's a small country.
Eller Filippinerne?
The Philippines is not the largest of countries. It, in using a phrase from boxing, punches above its weight.
Ja, mange små lande får store rosenord med på vejen, når de besøger præsidenten. Og måske har kopieringstasten sat sig fast på Obamas taleskrivers tastatur, for bemærkede du, hvad Obama også sagde, da han havde besøg af den hollandske regeringschef?
We have no stronger ally than the Netherlands.
Men er det ikke som om, man også har hørt nogenlunde den vending før?
We have no stronger ally than Australia.
Jo, og måske mere end en gang.
Poland is one of our closest and strongest allies. Great Britain is one of our closest, strongest allies. As I said earlier, Germany is one of our strongest allies. This state visit reflects the fact that the Republic of Korea is one of our strongest allies. Israel is one of our strongest allies. France is our oldest ally.
La France est notre plus ancien allié.
And continues to be one of our closest allies.
Italy is one of our strongest allies.
Japan is, of course, one of our strongest and closest allies.
Ja, USA har altså mange tætte og stærke allierede. Men hvad så med Prime Minister Helle Thorning-Schmidt? For vi er vel i Danmark en af USA's stærkeste og tætteste allierede. Ikke, Mr. President?
I also wanted to just say how much we appreciate the great alliance and partnership that we have with the Danish people on a whole range of international issues.
Hvad? Er vi hverken en af USA's tætteste eller stærkeste allierede? Nej, vi er bare en god allierede. Ja, nogle gange skal man lytte mere efter det, der ikke bliver sagt, end det, der bliver sagt.
Who shares your values? As president, Barack Obama has never visited Israel and refuses to recognize Jerusalem as its capital.
Governor, would you like to make your motion?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. This summer, I was proud to serve this party as the Platform Drafting Committee Chair. As the Chair, I come before you today to discuss two important matters related to our party's national platform. As an ordained United Methodist minister, I am here to attest and affirm that our faith and belief in God is central to the American story and informs the values we've expressed in our party's platform. In addition, President Obama recognizes Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, and our party's platform should as well. Mr. Chairman, I have submitted my amendment in writing, and I believe it is being projected on the screen for the delegates to see. I move adoption of the amendment as submitted and shown to the delegates.
A motion has been made. Is there a second? Is there any further discussion? Hearing none, the matter requires a two-thirds vote in the affirmative. All those delegates in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those delegates opposed say no.
No.
In the opinion of the... Let me do that again. All of those delegates in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those delegates opposed say no. I guess.
And then you've got to let them do what they're going to do.
I'll do that one more time. All those delegates in favor say aye.
Aye.
All those delegates opposed say no.
No.
In the opinion of the chair, two-thirds have voted in the affirmative. The motion is adopted. And the platform has been amended as shown on the screen. Thank you very much.
He knows America holds a deep and cherished relationship with Israel.
We speak the same language of freedom and justice.
And like the U.S., Israel respects the rights of people of all religions.
It's a deeply moving experience to be in Jerusalem, the capital of Israel.
Every state has the right to self-defense, and Israel must be able to defend itself by itself against any threat.